The Last Breath by Chaim Kluse. The hour of physical death is spiritually perilous too, for no bargaining or hiding can make this hour pass over you. It is a doorway everyone must journey through. The ancients knew and long foretold it. One should prepare if one hopes to see it through. So what happens in this hour? How should one be prepared? Surely there is no difference. What spiritual peril can lurk there? Satan, ready, his forces squared, his terrible evidence neatly prepared for this 60-minute court, so that he and his satellites of darkness might terrify the soul by their detailed report. For here in the hour's last minutes, the truth of the life lived revealed, what they sowed in their life now witness, what all supposed hidden, unsealed. This powerful unrest so deranges us that even saints can be tricked by the strife to lose their entry into the kingdom, to forget eternal life, turning suddenly from grace when confronted with their own Adam's face. The devil does all this to make the soul believe they are outside the Lord's care and his reach. So they themselves turn themselves away, wander in obscurity, forever astray. Adopted by darkness, they forsake the day. So take special care of the dying, for the devil infuses his own insanity to keep sins unconfessed and in hiding, and delay of a burial vanity. Prepare yourself too, dear soul, for your hour fast approaches, wherein the devil will bring the lighted coal full of hard reproaches. Prepare yourself and know this hour will touch you too. No force can snatch you from the Lord's hand, except your own will and you. When the devil accuses, remember your Christ, who died in your place, your sacrifice, to whom you've given your very life. When the devil presumes to say,
"You're mine,"
remember to rebuke him with truth divine.